All right, today's tutorial will be on a door hanger cat toy, and you will need a tapestry needle, a crochet hook. I use, this is a size F, and you can't see it anymore because it's all wore off. And you may want some catnip for this. You can add a bell, but you have to figure out the bell housing for it. Otherwise, the bell will not jingle because and you'll need polyfill also, or stuffing of your choice. The bell will not ring if you put the polyfill in with it, because it suffocates the bell and then you can't hear it. I don't know why. It just does, and you can't hear the bell. Alrighty. Let's start by making the ball. And I have another tutorial on how to make a ball, but we're going to redo it anyways. We'll do it on here because you need one for here. Okie dokie. So you're going to chain two. And you're going to put six into that second chain from the hook. Six single crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six. All right, we've got six in there. Now on the next row, you're gonna put two in every single crochet, which is pretty much more single crochet. Two single crochet into all the way around. So you should have 12 single crochets after you're done with this round. You in a little bit farther. Do, 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 do. You do not need to use the same catnip I'm using. You can use the catnip of your choice. I just like this brand because my cat, I only have one, tends to like this. But my sister's cats did also, and so did my neighbor's cats. They loved it too, so it's crazy. All right. And then on the next row, you're going to want to do two single crochets in the first stitch, and then in the next stitch one single crochet, and you're going to continue that all the way around until you get to the last one, till you got it all done. Do, 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 do. And this will hang off a doorknob. It doesn't matter if you have a doorknob or a door handle. It works either way. It will work. Unless you have a handle that's attached. Which could make it kind of a pain, but that's okay. You can always adapt it to the way you want it. Yes, you can. Okay, we are in. Okay, in the next row, you're going to want to chain two, chain one, then do your two single crochets in the first stitch, one more single crochet, and then another single crochet. And you're going to want to repeat that all the way around once again. And you're going to need to make two of these because, well, otherwise it would not be a ball. It would be half a ball. Just give me a second here. Losing my train of thought. My brain has just left the building. That's horrible. Please forgive me while I go find my mind. I don't know where it walked off to, but it did. Now, if you have a dog in your home, you're going to have to supervise your dog around this toy. So if you're gone, you may want to put it away. Because my golden doodle, like, tore one of the balls off the handle, literally. She literally just grabbed it and yanked it apart. Which can occasionally happen. Because dogs like cat toys as well, evidently. Or my dog was jealous. One of the two. Not sure. Alright. Now this is your last row, because you need five rounds. So you're going to chain one and do two single crochets in the first stitch. Then you're going to do a single crochet in the next. And in the next, and in the next. So you should have two, in the first stitch you should have two single crochet, then in the next three you should have one single crochet each. And you're going to repeat that all the way around. Lulu, lulu. Excuse me while I flip my yarn around. I must be tired today because my brain just isn't working the way I wanted to today. I don't know why. On strike or something. Do, 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 do. One, two, three. Now remember, you can like stop this video and catch up to me, or you can stop it and repeat it umpteen million times until you know the thing by heart. You can do this. It is okay. Alright. Okay. I've actually done that with videos, just so y'all know. Did I forget to mention that we needed the scissors? Because sometimes I forget to mention things we may need before we start. Okay, I'm going to be working on my second ball. Second half of the ball, okay. Got to have two of these, otherwise it's not exactly a ball. And you just make the second one the same as the first one. Two, three, four, five, six. Do, 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 do. This is how we crochet on a Wednesday. Yeah, and this video will be released in the afternoon, evidently, so. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And hit like to this video. I really need lots of likes. Lots of likes. I'd be really happy if you hit like. Really, really, really happy. Does that make sense? Do, do, do. Round and round we go. Or we stop. Nobody knows. Yeah, I'm kind of losing it today. I think I need to go take a nap. Oh, I didn't sleep really well last night. I had insomnia. Well, actually, I had a bad tooth, actually, that was bothering me. So I didn't get a lot of sleep. Don't you hate that? Your tooth hurts, but it doesn't hurt all day. But the minute you lay your head down, it starts to hurt like nuts. Ever have that problem? Almost there. Alrighty. Both halves done. And we can set them aside. Alright. Now, I want you to chain 80. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, make that 81. Okay. Now, I want you to do a half double crochet in the next 40. So in each one, it gets a half double crochet. On the next 40. And it's okay to stop and count to make sure you have the 40. I don't have 40 yet. I probably have 10. If you hear digging or anything, that is my dog. She is taking a nest in the corner. I don't know why she does that, but occasionally she does. Okay, now once you get your 40 done, you can take your crocheted ends and crochet them together, or you can sew them together. I'm just gonna do what I usually do, and I usually just quickly crochet it with a stitch. I crochet it together just like that. That way I don't have to cut the yarn or anything because I have to continue on anyway. Okay, now with the remaining 40, what you want to do you want to do front loop in one stitch, back loop in the other. It's to make it curl, but you have to do three. Okay, I'm going to do back loop first. So you can either do back loop or front loop first, but you have to alternate it through the whole thing. Otherwise, it will not curl. So I'm going to do start with back loop and put three half double crochets in there. So it's a half double crochet. I'm going to put three in there. And now I have to go to the next stitch and do the front loop there. And do three half double crochets in there. And continue to do it through the whole thing. And the idea is to get it to twist. So, and that's the effect we want for it to twist. So it's going to be front loop, back loop, front loop, back loop. Oh, you know what I mean. And if you accidentally skip a stitch here and there, it's okay. No one's going to know because it doesn't get noticed, which is kind of cool with this particular way of crocheting. You're going to know, but no one else is going to know. Let's just put it that way. So you just do front loop, back loop. It'll look kind of funky, but you can fix it. I'll show you how to fix it in a second. Because right now it looks like, what the heck are you doing? Which is okay. I mean, it's okay because we can get it to look appropriate once we are done with this particular back and forth here. Okay, all you have to do is twist it so it starts to twist on itself. See, and it'll look like that. It'll be awesome. You can make this longer or shorter, all up to you. You don't have to do like 40 for this. You can have it a little bit longer. It's all up to you, really. I just did the... you can do a little less than 40 for the handle, but I prefer to do at least 40 there to make enough room for... Depending on your doorknob, I guess. I mean, if you have a smaller doorknob... Oh, and depending on the location of your doorknob, you may want to make this a little longer or a little shorter. Depending on how that all is. I hope I'm not putting my head in the way on this. I'm going to be so mad if I did. So mad. Do Hang on for a second, I'm not happy with that one. Almost to the end. Come on. And there we are at the end. Okay, now just twist it. And go up right here. And there you go. A spiral. It's a little sloppy, but that's okay. Okay, now we're gonna take this and sew these two together. Now what I do is, there's two ways of doing this particular, sewing this on. First I'm going to get this. You could sew the ball halfway closed and attach it to there. Or you can take one of these and put your crochet hook through the middle of the disc here and pull your string through there and then go over a little bit through between two stitches and bring your other piece there. Because you already got this string here, so you just tie it in a knot, make sure it's secure tightly, and then you just tighten a knot and there you go, it's attached. Then you just bring these two together and start sewing. What I do is I go through a couple of stitches. And then just grab a stitch where I want to begin. It doesn't matter where. All up to you. Then you just start stitching all the way around. If you find that you have extra stitches on this ball, just, you know, just do double somewhere, you know, just collect it up. Which happens occasionally. It depends on how you crochet it. I mean, the more relaxed you are, the bigger your crochet will be. The more tense you are, the smaller it'll be. Usually. You just want to make sure that you sew all the way around and tuck your strings in. I mean, just tuck them in. That way you don't have to trim them or tuck them somewhere else. Just tuck them right in the ball. Now you're going to want to leave a gap in here so you can put your polyfill in and your catnip. And if you are attempting to do a bell. If you're going to attempt to do bells, check to make sure that it is ringing, you know, with whatever you're using, material or container of some sort. You can even use plastic plastic canvas and make a container with that. Just giving you ideas. I'm not going to put a bell in here. Because my cat does not care if there's bells in it or not. She will play with it regardless. Regardless. A little lumpy today. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Okay. When you get to this point, you can put your catnip in. Make sure you got your polyfill ready, which I don't, because I got a full bag up here. I usually use the other one, but the other one's downstairs, and I don't feel like running down to get it. Some people fill these completely with catnip. I do not. I find that the cat plays with it either way. And then you just want to stuff some polyfill in there to keep your catnip in there while you sew it, the hole a little bit smaller. Now you can add as much catnip to these as you want. I mean, that's up to you. You can, like I said, you can completely fill it. But if you are putting a bell in there, you may want to watch how much polyfill you put in. Because like I said, the polyfill will suffocate the bell, and the bell will not, you won't be able to hear it. If you've been to one of my Etsy shops, you know that that one particular is dedicated to cat toys. I've been making cat toys, oh, I'd say for close to, the shop says I started in 2011, but I've been making cat toys for, oh, I don't know, quite a few years. I've learned by experience. And you just sew her up when you're comfortable with what's in it. This is being made for my kitty cat, so she's feeling kind of left out lately. We're not playing with her enough, I guess. My cat is an adult. She is almost 4 years old. She plays all the time. She actually wants us to throw things for her, so so and then we just tuck the string in a couple of times. That's what I do. And I like knot it, you know, like put a loop over. And there. It's completely finished. Woohoo! And it does not matter what color you use. You can put a color, different colors here and there, or you can even do different colors in your chain if you want. All up to you. Anyway, that's the end of this tutorial. I'll catch you all later. I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do so. I'm going to try to do these every Wednesday from now on. It doesn't mean it's going to be this. It may be something different. And I will be seeing you with another tutorial next Wednesday. hit that like button, share. If you want to leave a comment, go right ahead. You have any questions, don't be afraid to leave that in the comments as well. I will read them and I will get back to you either in another video or if I can write in the comment section, I will. It depends on my computer. Some days it works really good that way and sometimes it doesn't. Anyway, catch you all later. Bye-bye.